welcome to chapter one of my story, Blood Moon Highway. Me and my wife riding full speed on my motorbike down our long road, wind in my hair, hands around my waist. We pulled into this petrol station. I fill up the tank. My wife is smoking a cigarette leaning against the bike. I'm getting some stuff for the road. When I exit, I start walking back to the bike. Everything goes black. Day becomes a dark and stormy night, and I am alone. Everyone has gone, and the things around me look old and falling apart. And I'm just left, me and my bike. I panic and start looking for my wife, but I can't find her anywhere. So I get back on the bike and do a quick ride around the area. Panicked, not knowing what to do, I race off as if I was being chased by something. I have to find her. Where has she gone? So many questions buzzing around my head. And hold up. What the flying fuck is going on here? It was daytime when I went into the petrol station. Just to pay for the petrol, get some water. Now everything looks like shit. The sky is black. The moon's gone fucking blood red. And where's my damn wife? We are hundreds of miles away from home, so it's not like she just hot-footed it and went home. The faster my mind raced, the faster I pushed my bike until something made me stop. Something wasn't right. The air smelled different. The best way I could describe it is a strong bloody smell, mixed with candy floss. I know it sounds fucking nuts to me, but yeah, it's candy floss blood smell is filling the air in this strange apocalypse world. It is somehow now my reality. So, what to do? My wife is missing. All I have is my bike and a few supplies. I don't care what's going on in this world. I have to find her. I have to find my wife. That's all that matters. Back to the gas station, after sat thinking for a moment, I decided to get back. Seems like a good place to start trying to work out what's going on. I mean, that's where it all started. So where better to start trying to put the puzzle together? Plus, I need to see if there are any smokes. My wife vanished along with the only pack of smokes we had, so I got back on, revved my bike up, headed back. Didn't take long. I mean, fuck the speed limit, I don't think it really matters in this strange world. My ass is stuck. I pulled up to the gas station. Cautiously, stared at it across from the dirt road. Everything looked like it had been abandoned for 50 years. But the pumps, the advertisements, it was all up to date. It said 2024. On the newspapers, it's just everything looked like it had been left to rot. Seeing only hours had passed since I pulled up at a fully working modern gas station. Now it looks like it went to shit over 50 years ago. Just confused the shit out of me. So here's what we got. A gas station looks like it's been rotting 50 years with no one looking after it. Yet the papers are up to date. The stock is up to date. It's just all old and dusty. Looking, I checked the pumps. They all work. Plenty of petrol. started walking towards the entrance of the gas station. As I opened the door, the lights, a really dim yellow glow, and nothing looked too strange. This was one of those gas stations where you fix your car, had a garage attached to it. I went up to the counter to look around, just to see if there was anyone there. No one to be found. So I went behind the counter and sat on the stool that was next to the register, looking around my surroundings, trying to give myself a moment to think. I planned my next move. I looked at the rack of smokes, took down a packet, sparked one up. Thank fuck. For that, can you blame me? The world's just gone to fuck shit, and I've lost my wife. I really need to get a game plan here. So I finished my smoke and started looking around the gas station to see what was laying around. I thought best start in the back rooms. You never know what shit you're gonna find in a place this far from, well, anywhere. So I went to the back room, tried the handle a few times, seems it was locked, frustratingly, trying the door handle a few times. I just gave the door a few kicks, it opened the back room. It was strange. At first glance, all I could see was filing cabinets. I thought nothing of it, really. It had a working garage next to it, so maybe it was sales records for both parts. Shit like that. So I didn't really give them much thought. I tried the light switch. Again, a dim yellow glow accompanied with a low buzzing sound. What the hell is it with these lights? We got yellow in the shop. In the shop floor, green in the back room. Still, not the biggest thing on my mind at the moment. I saw an empty employee locker with the letter J on it. It was unlocked, so I took a look. I had a backpack, water bottle, local map, medium sized hunting knife. The backpack was perfect as well. As well as my saddlebags on the bike, I could at least grab a few extra things for the road. I have a feeling I'm gonna need them. I also had a very bad gut feeling I was gonna need the knife. I slipped the knife into my boot, took the backpack, and carried on looking around the back room. After the locker, there was a small desk with a radio. I flicked the radio on, just out of curiosity, started turning the dial. To my shock, nothing. At the end of the dial, there was a small humming noise, not like static, almost like as if the hum was there on purpose. I grabbed the radio, stuck it in my bag. After giving the office a few looks over, finding a few other bits, like a first aid kit, stuff like that, I headed back to the main floor. Food, fluid, and of course, I'm gonna need cigarettes. So, yeah, I filled half the backpack up with cigarettes. But on the way out of the back room, I bumped into one of those filing cabinets. And it sounded like there was some sort of glass in it. So I stopped and opened up the bottom drawer, and there was a few jars with bullets in them. 45 caliber pistol rounds. I held the jar looking at them, which encouraged me to open the drawers of the rest of the cabinets. Interestingly, not a single file or piece of paperwork there. It was full of what we call prepper kits, survival stuff. What the fuck is a garage in the ass end of nowhere doing with ammo, knives, military rations? Shit me, I need a bigger bag. So closed at the filing cabinets. Took a few rations, stayed with me, sat in the office chair in the room, staring at the jar of bullets while I smoked my second cigarette. So if there's a jar of bullets, where's the gun? First I checked under the desk. Nothing. I opened up the first drawer. And it was a few logbooks and stuff like that. But under it was a lockbox. I took the hunting knife and cracked the lockbox open to find a black 1911 pistol. So it's the first time. It's the first time I smiled since I found out the world gone to shit and my wife had disappeared. I took the gun, checked it over, loaded the 45 bullets into the mag, tucked it into my jeans. It was starting to get very windy outside. I felt like a storm was coming. So I took what I had in my backpack, made a plan. I knew from our house to the gas station was about 100 miles, give or take. I didn't know what the road ahead of me had in store. I decided this was a good place to lay low for a bit. Thing is, it's all well and good to say, yeah, okay, I'm gonna camp here, wait for daylight. What the fuck am I gonna do when daylight never comes? Where the hell is my wife? What's going on? Why is that smell everywhere? And the moon blood red? I tried looking at the map to see if I could get any idea of where I was. Or if there was no chance of me sleeping. Not with the worry of my wife being missing. On the map there was a few points marked. Gas station was one of them. Right away, something stood out. The map was strange. I planned our trip. I knew the lay of the land, where we were going. Everything on this map was not what I saw on my map before I left the house. Gas station was marked, and then there were 4 points on the map, almost the same distance from the gas station, each one just in different directions. They were marked with a red question mark on them. So this is something. I don't know what it is, but it's something. So I just put the map into my backpack, found some food, grabbed a good looking bottle of whiskey for the road. If I have to camp out anywhere or sleep in the open, at least it will keep me warm. And it's good for cleaning wounds. I don't know what to expect. Hope for the best, prepare for the worst. Hopefully you will come out of this shitstorm swinging. Even though it was nighttime, and I should not have gone out in the storm, I just couldn't settle. All I could think about was my wife, so I got back on the bike and decided to head to one of the points on the map with the question mark. I think all should be about 30 miles away from the gas station in each direction, north, east, south, and west. I headed to the north question mark first, about 15 miles headed north. I slammed my brakes at the sight of a very large jellyfish glowing and floating in the middle of the road. Bike stopped about 5 feet away from it. I just stared at the big light up jellyfish fucking floating in the air. Either they're putting LSD in the water, or I'm further from home than I want to admit. Honestly, my gut's telling me not even in the same dimension anymore. Big floating jellyfish on the road? What the fuck. Well, that's part one. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for taking the time to hear my story. Part two will be coming soon. And buckle up. It's going to be one hell of a ride.